Hey guys, welcome back to the YouTube channel. My name's Will, and today I'm going to show you how you can sign up for Printify and Shopify and start your print-on-demand business. So first things first, head on over to Printify, sign up for an account. I've already started the application. I'm going to save it. I'm here to sell products online. Nope. Artist. No, I'm just playing around. Hit next. Couple questions. Yada, yada, yada. Design your first artwork. Design your first product. Add a store name. Add your personal details and connect your store and start selling. So we'll go ahead and design a product. And from here, we'll go ahead and choose something that we like. I'm going to go with men's clothing, a hoodie. And I'm going to choose my favorite hoodie, which is going to be the Lane 7. This one, but I like the hoodie, not the zip up. And from here, we will go ahead and find something that you enjoy. So $23.51, $8, 3 to 4 business days, all these colors, 9.2 rating, and you can see it goes down pretty quickly. So I am going to consider just using this guy and hit start designing. And from here, I can add my design. So I just made a video that is how to export in the correct PNG format. So I'm going to go ahead and go and get that same. And when I go here, I'll be able to export it. And it takes a second. That's fine. And what we can do here is we can make it as big or small as we want. I've already made it pretty big, so I'm going to just lower it a little and maybe go something like that. And then over here we can, you know, make it in the middle, we can put it in the center, we can tag it to the bottom, but I'm going to go ahead and tag it to the top so that all the font is chosen. The next thing we can do is go over here to the colors. Okay, go away. What is going on? Sorry, bear with me. Okay, so we're back. I'm going to add my design, go to my device. Once again, click on this. I'm not going to worry so much about this again. So we have this. You just crashed, bro. And once you have that, we can go ahead to my library, new design, add design, and we can change the color. We have all these colors available, so I'm going to do black, and then I'm going to unselect this white one by going up here to all colors and eliminating it. And now I can go to this preview, and it will preview this thing. So going ape shit, straight bananas. So we'll go ahead and save the product. It switched over to a Gildan 8500, which is not what I selected. And we'll go ahead and edit the listing. And within the listing, we're going to want to set our thumbnail to be obviously the one on the front. And then we can switch our title to be something like Gorilla Hoodie Premium Pullover Unisex Blend Hoodie or something like that. You want to insert keywords here, so like designer hoodie, black hoodie, right? All these different keywords that people can search. And then for as far as this goes, Google doesn't like repetitive things, so you're going to want to like delete this and write something ridiculous premium hoodie with a gorilla on the front, gorilla hoodie keep you warm, yada yada yada, something like that. And then you can come down to the pricing and you can select all by going here, and then you can just change the price to $50, right, or whatever you think is fair, and say you don't want to sell 3XLs, so you just eliminate it. And you do something like this, and you have your details, and you will save as a draft. And the reason you'll save as a draft is because you haven't connected to a store yet. So what we can do here is we're going to leave this and we're going to go start a business. So let's go ahead and enter our email. Just okay, make a password up really quick. Cool hoodies, my guy. Something like that, right? And then that's going to create a store name. You'll have a thing. Go ahead and save your password. And your store is ready to go. Now that you are ready to go, you can continue to make your store. So we'll go here and we'll have to go. Oh my goodness. I'm just playing around. No. $0. Next. You don't really need to do anything. I guess you do. So my name is Will Fritz. Blah, blah, blah. Yep. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then you would go create your store. And then you'd have to set up payments and whatnot, but we're not really going to do that at this level. So what you're going to want to do is go to apps, and within the apps, you can customize your store. And you want the Printify app, I believe. It's been a while since I've done this. So we'll do Printify, print on demand, that is the one. And there's another service called Printful that makes it pretty easy. So we'll go ahead and add that app. We'll come back over here and we'll connect our store. It's a Shopify store. Enter the shop URL. We can find that by going to right here. So this is going to be the URL that you enter. Go ahead and copy that, paste it into here, and connect. And that should load. And you're going to want to hit install the app, let it do its thing. There was a problem loading this app. Of course there was. Probably because I didn't finish the Printify. Oh my goodness. Well, sign in, please. I'm not a robot, I promise. Okay, add the store name, add a store name. You know, let's create a store name. Cool hoodies, dude. Or what do we do with my guy? Okay, we'll save. Store settings saved. As your personal detail, no thank you. I guess we can though. Name of business, blah 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 blah. One of the blah blah. Save. Oh, Los Angeles. Okay, so we saved that and now we're good. And we will try this once again. We have my news. Did it work? It worked, hey. Okay, so my stores within here, we have our unisex gorilla hoodie. So from here we can publish it and it'll now publish our setting. We're within the Shopify app. So I guess it did work. It just took a second to load. And while that's publishing, we should be good here. We don't have to do anything. And we can now go to settings, and within the settings we're gonna have to go and disable our password. And the only way you can do that is by selecting a plan and updating a payment method, which we're not really gonna do right now. So I'm trying to find the settings. I think it might be. Yeah, so it's going to be under online store. Yeah. And probably preferences. Your password. Yes, we're going to change our password to cool hoodies. We are going to save it. And if you are curious about what that is not my password to log in. And so that's just so that we can go to the account, to the website, and then enter the password, and then we can see the shop. We won't be able to collect payments unless we select a plan and enter credit card information. So once you're in your preferences, you can change the homepage title. So cool hoodies, my guy. And then enter a little description about your store. So you'd be like, this is a shop full of cool hoodies. Cool hoodies, my guy. And I'm inserting keywords. My keyword in this particular case is cool hoodies. So cool hoodies offers premium pullovers, right? Premium pullovers. That's another keyword. Perfect, affordable gifts. Affordable gifts, another keyword. And you don't want it over 165 characters. So once you save that, now when people go to your website, this will pop up in Google and this will be the description below it. Now, Google is kind of slow. So it's see in store. Let's go ahead and see in store. So cool hoodies, my guy, Shopify. So we need to enter the password. Whoops, which is going to be right here. Enter the password, cool hoodies. And when we're here, we are now in the cool hoodies website, which is pretty blank right now, but you have the option. It's here. You've integrated Shopify and Printify. People can now purchase and add to the cart and check out. Well, they won't be able to buy because you don't have the password set up, but you were able to do that. And if you ever want to do some SEO, what you're going to want to do is go to your products within your Shopify. Printify is now useless. All Printify is going to be good for is updating your more products. So now you can just make a product and then hit the publish button and it'll go right to your Printify store. And then in here, what you can do is a bunch of different SEO tactics. So this is the title of the web page. Also, I don't know if you noticed this, but it says Cool Hoodies, My Guy, right? Because that's what we put as our shop title. And then so when we go in here, Gorilla Hoodie, Premium Pullover, Unisex, blah, 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 that came from Printify. We already did it. It's no longer that default title. And we also updated the description. Now this is different from this. I can go ahead and download it down here, right? And I can make it say Gorilla Hoodie, Premium Pullover, Black Hoodie, so gangsta, so fresh, so clean. And then you can make it so it just says Gorilla Hoodie on your URL slug. And then you can add a little bit more detail here about your item. And then when you save it, it'll save all this in your new search engine listing preview. See, this is the title of the item right here, right? So this should now say example 47, right? And I hit save. And then I go to like, this is what I do all day. Gang, gang, right? And then I hit save. Well, now when I go into here, it should have updated example 47. I guess I spelled it wrong. And the details should be right here. Ridiculous. This is what I do all day. Gang, gang. However, the title tag of the page is not this. So let me make it a little more obvious. So now when I go here and I refresh the page, it should just say Gorilla Hoodie. It should. And the URL has updated, which is good. Cool Hoodies, see, it updated to just Gorilla Hoodie, and then Cool Hoodies, my guy, is my shop name. And that's basically how SEO works. And if you want to update your alt image tags, you go right here and you can go Gangsta Hoodie and you can save it. And now when people, when the image won't load, at least Gangsta Hoodie will. And that is a very quick tutorial on integrating Printify and Shopify. Thanks for watching.